This Mass is being offered for the repose of the soul of William Porter. We have a few announcements. Welcome to St. Michael the Archangel Parish. If you would like more information about St. Michael's, welcome packets are located at the greeter's table. Bulletins and offertory baskets are located at each doorway. Please drop off your envelopes and offerings in the baskets. Grab a bulletin for parish updates and a food drive bag. If you are interested in becoming a volunteer for any of the parish ministries here at St. Michael's, please see the ladies at the greeter's table to sign up. Have a Merry Christmas. And as we prepare for Mass, let us turn off our cell phones and observe a moment of silence.
Hymn is O Come All Ye Faithful. Please stand.
I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Yeah.
O God, who made this most sacred night radiant with the splendor of the true light, grant, we pray, that we who have known the mysteries of his light on earth may also delight in his gladness in heaven. For this reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Upon those who dwelt in the land of gloom, a light has shone. You have brought them abundant joy and great rejoicing. As they rejoice before you, as at the harvest, as people make merry when dividing spoils. For the yoke that burdened them, the pole on their shoulder, and the rod of their taskmaster, you have smashed, as on the day of Midian. For every boot that tramped in battle, every cloak rolled in blood, will be burned as fuel for flames. For a child is born to us, a son is given us. Upon his shoulder, dominion rests. They name him Wonder Counselor, God Hero, Father Forever, Prince of Peace. His dominion is vast and forever peaceful, from David's throne and over his kingdom, which he confirms and sustains by judgment and justice, both now and forever. The zeal of the Lord of Hosts will do this. The word of the Lord. Justly and devoutly in this age, as we await the blessed hope, the appearance of the glory of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ. who gave himself for us to deliver us from all lawlessness and to cleanse him for himself a people as his own, eager to do what is good. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And suddenly there was a multitude of the heavenly hosts with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
As I've been told, the 2 o'clock, some of you I have not seen since the first of the year, and some of you are getting thinner, and some of you are expanding, and some of you are just getting taller. So I hope it's what all of you want, because you're going to have to accept yourself, bloom where you're planted, but it's good to see you all. On Sunday, June 1st, 1975, Daryl Gore was on an oil rig in the Gulf of Mexico. Suddenly, the rig wobbled, tipped over, and fell into the sea. Daryl was trapped inside a room in a rig. As the rig sank deeper and deeper into the sea, the lights in the room went out, and the room began to fill with water. Thrashing about in the darkness, he accidentally found a huge air bubble. He put his head in it. He thrust his head there in the corner, and he kept breathing. That was what he gave thanks for originally. Then a horrifying thought finally came over him. He said, I'm buried alive. Sent a chill down his spine. He began to pray out loud. He said, a wonderful thing happened. It was remarkable. He said later, I found myself talking to someone. Jesus was there with me. There was no illumination, nothing physical. But I sensed him, a comforting presence. He was real. He was there. For the next 22 hours, the presence continued to comfort Darrell. But now the oxygen supply inside the bubble was giving out. Death was inevitable. It was just a matter of time. Then a second remarkable thing happened. Darrell saw a tiny spark of light shimmering in the pitch black water. Was it real, or after 22 hours and losing oxygen, breathing carbon dioxide? Was he hallucinating? So he squinted again. The light was real, it was getting bigger. All of a sudden, a diver's helmet came into view. After 22 hours, he was saved, his nightmare was over. Rescue had come. The world at the time of Jesus was like the room in the oil rig under the water. Totally dark. You and I take these things up here for granted now. We flip on the switch, and the only time we notice is if they don't go on. We get upset. Okay, we also notice if there's ever a monsoon again in the years coming forward, that when they go, power goes out, we notice. But back then, there were no lights except oil lamps and torches. Have you ever been in a room lit by an oil lamp? It doesn't show very much light. A torch, not much better. When I was younger, okay, I was a kid, you would go into these caves on these tours, and they would turn out the light. And there was no light. Your eyes couldn't adjust, totally pitch black. And you realized, wow, that's what it was for Darrell. That's really what it was like for the world before Jesus came. The world was dark, figuratively, literally, symbolically. There was no light. There was no hope. There was no joy. Except in one nation, one tiny little group of people had a spark of hope. The rest of the world ignored it. For them, it was total pitch blackness. But for the Israelite people, they had this little spark. God had said, but you know what? It got darker and darker and darker because for them, this whole thing lasted 2,000 years. That's a long time to keep hope alive. You and I are complaining after, what, 10 months of masks, of not being able to go places, of having to stay in our own little bubble, people telling us things. Now we're starting to see it. People in stores flying off the handle. There was one lady who got so mad, she flipped off, took off her mask, and the store person confronted her. She picked up her cart, which is, I would have loved to see that, and threw it at the lady. So we're starting to see what happens in a world without hope and light, all darkness. Not only that, the time of Jesus, women had no rights. They were second-class citizens. Slaves were seen as better than women, in the Roman Empire included. Men had the right to rape boys, men, women. As long as they were acting like men, the law said, that's fine, that's what we Romans want. Babies that weren't accepted, whether had their throats slit by their parents and thrown in the garbage pile, or they were put in the sewers under Rome, anywhere else in the place too. They didn't have a sewer system. They were taken outside the city and left on a hill to die. Old people, when they got past their usefulness to society, were set out in the wilderness or killed. There was no hope. This life was all they knew, and it was miserable. One third of the population at the time of Jesus was slaves, most of who could never get out of their slavery. Once in a while, somebody bought their way out. You had sports where if somebody didn't get killed, it wasn't worth going to. gladiators, chariot races. All these things were for death. Death was the prominent thing. There was no life for anyone. It's interesting that you weren't even expected to be faithful in marriage. There was one epitaph written on a tomb that shows how astounding faithfulness was between husband and wife. It said, he was faithful to his wife for 40 years. They were stunned. How could you be that way? Faithful. When society didn't care. There was a man who threw a party for the emperor. The emperor came and he said, you know what? I'm going to have sex with your wife in the back room. They went back there, had it. The emperor came out and critiqued her. And then one of the servants put the glass and the host threw him into a pit of man-eating eels. This is the kind of darkness that Jesus came into the world for. There are epidemics, people dying by the millions. The plague of Justinian killed 50 million people. It's one of the worst in the history of the human race. It was half of the world's population. They're calling this a pandemic, an epidemic, and only 300,000 have died. Yes, it's a tragedy, but it's not the numbers that we've seen in the past. Yet, we in America are upset, we're complaining, we're people telling me, Father, I don't have hope anymore, I'm angry. This is the kind of world that Jesus came into. The prophet Isaiah just told us, the people in darkness have seen a great light. The light that guided the shepherds and the magi. To what? To the true light that came into the world. To somebody who was going to bring, in fulfillment of all the prophecies, hope, true love, true peace, true joy, forgiveness, compassion. All the things the world did not have before. All the things we take for granted. And we're shocked when something doesn't happen. There were no universities to learn from. There were no hospitals, nursing homes, clinics. There was nothing. Their beer and wine tasted horrible. But it's all they knew. We've made the recipes, they're horrible. Jesus came, and then when he came, he left something. He left two things. He left the church, the mystical body of his here on earth. What did the church do? It spread the message of light. St. Paul, St. Peter, St. Timothy, all went around spreading, the 12 apostles. Light of Jesus to the world. What happened? This organization set by God grew faster than any organization has ever grown in the history of the human race before Jesus or since Jesus. Christianity. That's what Jesus did. What did the church do? It founded universities, founded hospitals and clinics, took care of the poor, the elderly, the unwanted babies. It brought light into the world, into people's lives. And for once, people had hope. And it was that that helped it grow. No longer was the world and this life it. We are living in an age right now that knows all of these things. Abortion, euthanasia. You get more time in prison for embezzling $10,000 than you do killing a 7-year-old. Or a 3-year-old, and on and on and on. We have restrictions because the government says it's a pandemic. Yes, it's critical, because we haven't known anything else. To us, it seems important. We have religious leaders that are telling us it's okay, or that we can't receive our sacraments, receive Jesus, be with the light of the world, and people are upset. We have political parties doing crazy things, just like they did in Rome when Jesus came. And we have something they didn't have. We've already got the light of Christ. Christmas is just there to remind us about the joy, about the peace, about the compassion, true joy, true peace. Not the peace the world gives, but the peace only Jesus can give. We already have that. At Christmas, we put up lights. We give presents. And originally it was an imitation. The lights, an imitation of the light that Jesus brought. The presents, an imitation of the present God sent. Every time we see a light, we should think, light of the world, Jesus Christ, and all the things he's done and brought. Every time we receive a present or give one, God's present to us, Jesus Christ. That's what we celebrate at Christmas. The light that came into the world and brought a way to get rid of darkness. Yeah, back then the nights were still just as dark. Oil lamps threw no hardly any light. Torches threw hardly any light. But people, their mindset had changed. Their hearts had changed. So that it was no longer oppressive. They knew this life wasn't all there was. Jesus had come to lead them, to show them how life could be better here and in the next one. You and I have that light within us. We don't have to wait for Jesus to come again. By virtue of our baptism, we have the light of Jesus within us. And it is up to us, like St. Paul, like St. Peter, like St. Timothy, and the apostles, to let the world know. Instead of focusing in on the political system, instead of focusing in on the culture, instead of focusing in on the negativity, remember what Christmas was all about. Bringing joy and peace and compassion and forgiveness and love. A love the world had never known. Unconditional love. Not to get a show respect for our human beings, fellow human beings, because we want to get them to heaven. This is why the light of the world came. This is what Jesus did. Like Daryl in the middle of the ocean, that was the world, all dark, without hope. And that one little light, that one little baby, brought all the stuff we assume and we take for granted. Until it starts to go away. And then we have to remember something. We can change it back to the good times. We can bring Jesus into the world again. So that once again, the darkness pushes away. Our depression goes away. Our despondency disappears. Christmas reminds us that it's up to us to show the light of Christ around our area, our families, our friends, our community. Not to buy into what the society is trying to push us into. People put on masks, and all of a sudden they're not friendly anymore. They're not polite. They just stare at you as if you saying hello to them is the most horrible insult in the world. Change it. Wiggle your eyebrows and smile, and they can see it up here. Bring the light of Christ to the world, a world that right now needs it more than it's ever needed before, because our society is way worse than Rome at the time of Jesus. Christmas is our celebration, our being reminded that we are Christians, followers of Christ, Christ givers to the world, because he gave that to us at our baptism. So, the lights we have around, they're pale imitation of what we can do with the light of Christ. The presents we receive are pale imitation of the present we can give to somebody else by bringing Jesus Christ to them, like God did at that time of great darkness. We can do to the darkness today. God bless you. I believe. This blessed night we rejoice because our Savior has been born. Let us pray to the Father who has shown us endless love by sending us his only Son.
For the leaders of our church, especially our Holy Father, Pope Francis, that through their work they may continue to spread the good news of our Savior, let us pray to the Lord. For all the members of our church throughout the world, that they may share the joy of this holy night and rejoice in the light of faith, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all mothers, that they may follow the example of Blessed Mary, who so lovingly welcomed the infant Christ into her life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our community, especially parents and children, that all families may appreciate the true spirit of Christmas giving, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the souls of all who shared our Christmas joy in times past on earth, that they may come to eternal glory, especially William Porter, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, you sent your only Son into the world, truly God and truly man. Mindful of your great gift, we confidently place our needs before you, and we ask in Christ our Lord.
Amen. Our offertory hymn is Away in a Manger.
Father.
May this oblation of today's feast be pleasing to you, O Lord, we pray, that through this most holy exchange, we may be found in the likeness of Christ, in whom our nature is united to you, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. From the mystery of the Word made flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our mind, so that as we recognize in him God made visible, we may be caught up through him in love of things invisible. And so the angels and archangels with thrones and dominions, love the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glories without end, we acclaim. These holy and blemished sacrifices, which you offer firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world. Give your servant Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, and all those holding to the truth, and on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants who are living. And all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer this sacrifice of praise, while they offer for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls and hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred night on which Blessed Mary, the Immaculate Virgin, brought forth the Savior for this world, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord, Jesus Christ, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace and command, be delivered from eternal damnation, and count among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable. May it become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, as Almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands. Once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. the mystery of faith. Into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord. We, your servants and your holy people, offer your glorious majesty from the gifts you have given us, as pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, holy bread of eternal life, the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, holy sacrifice, the spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, sight of your divine majesty. To all of us who, for this participation at the altar, you see the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith, and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. Bless also your servants who, those sinners, hope in your abundant mercies. Graciously grant some share fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon. Through Christ our Lord, then we continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. We dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not in our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the words of my soul shall be saved.
Our communion hymn is Night of Silence, Silent Night.
Destroy.
First off, you've got to cut a CD with mine. You really should. You've got to have something like that. That was really good. I didn't know, but now we know what the people in these shows he puts on can see when he's on stage. Yeah. And on behalf of my mother and myself, I wish you all a very Merry Christmas. And I'll see you a blessed, holy, and better New Year. Okay? Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord our God, that we are gladdened by participation in the feast of our Redeemer's Nativity, and through an honorable way of life, become worthy of union with him who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
But I have to give you a blessing. And in response, you know, amen, 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 okay? May the God of infinite goodness, who by incarnation of his Son has driven darkness from the world, and by that glorious birth has illumined this most holy night, drive far from you the darkness of vice and evil, and illumine your hearts with the light of virtue and truth.
Amen.
May God the will that the great joy of his Son's saving birth be announced to shepherds by the angel, fill your minds with the gladness and hope he gives, and make you heralds of his gospel.
Amen.
And may God, who by the incarnation brought together the earthly and heavenly realm, fill you with the gift of his peace and favor, and make you sharers with the church in heaven.
Amen.
St. Michael the Archangel,
defend us from the devil. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And in the name of the Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, thrust in and all Satan and all evil spirits, who prowl about the world seeking to ruin his souls. Amen.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have
mercy on us. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Our recessional hymn is Go Tell It on the Mountain.